Hello everyone, welcome to the next session on AC Fundamental. Here we are going to study the pure response of pure R, L and C with AC, that is pure resistance, pure inductance and pure capacitance with AC. So this is the learning, this is the aim of this today's lecture. Here we are at the end of this session, you may be elaborate to the response of a pure RLC with AC, draw the waveform and phasor diagram from instantaneous voltage, current and power, derive the relationship between voltage, current and power in all cases. So let us consider that let a pure resistance of R ohm is connected across the AC supply, which is represented by V is equal to Vm sin omega t. So this is the pure resistance which is excited by the AC voltage. V is equal to Vm sin omega t, that is, this is the blue waveform indicates V is equal to Vm sin omega t. Okay, so voltage phasor is in phase with the reference value or in the with the reference reference side. So let us understand how we'll calculate instantaneous current. According to Ohm's law, the instantaneous current carried by the resistance is equal to instantaneous current is equal to instantaneous voltage divided by resistance. How we'll represent instantaneous voltage? Instantaneous voltage is equal to Vm sin omega t. Okay, so Vm divided by R sin omega t. So Vm by R is nothing but the value of Im sin omega t, where Im is equal to Vm upon R. It is clear from above equation that I is also having the plus 0 angle or sin omega t plus 0, and Vm is also having the angle sin omega t plus 0. It is clear that voltage across the resistance and current through the resistance are in phase with each other. That is, the current is also having the same phase angle with respect to the voltage. That is, its maximum value is Im, which is equal to Vm upon R. The maximum value will occur at the same instant. That is, voltage phasor and current phasor both are in phase. Similarly, as Vm is equal to Vm by R, if I substitute Vm is equal in terms of I as Im is replaced by Im, it can be replaced by root 2 I. Vm can be replaced as root 2 V. Root 2, root 2 get cancelled. So IRMS is equal to VRMS upon resistance. So how to calculate instantaneous power? So instantaneous power P is equal to instantaneous voltage V into instantaneous voltage I, that is Vm sin omega t into Im sin omega t. Okay, so Vm Im sin omega t, how it will give? It will give you Vm Im sin square omega t, can be represented as 1 minus cos 2 omega t. Okay, if I multiply this Vm Im inside the bracket, it will give me Vm Im by 2 minus Vm Im by 2 cos 2 omega t. So here this Vm Im by 2 is called as the constant term, whereas Vm Im by 2 into cos 2 omega 2 is called as the pulsating or fluctuating power. This is a constant power and fluctuating power. If we take the average over the full cycle, so if you see in this waveform, the power waveform, okay, if you see this power waveform, as the voltage, current and both are increasing, it will reaches to the maximum value when Vm Im is the maximum. Again, it starts decreasing with the decrease in the voltage. Again, it is V into I, voltage and current both are negative, but the power is again positive, because negative negative into positive. So the waveform, this is the waveform of the instantaneous, but the instantaneous power is cannot be taken for the measurement. Here we have to take the average value. So average power, how will calculate the average power? Power is never RMS, power is always in terms of average. So average power is equal to what? Average of Vm Im by 2 minus average of Vm Im by cos 2 omega t over the full cycle. Okay, if we take over the full cycle, that is, average level is taken for half cycle of the fundamental. Half cycle of the fundamental is completed over here. If we take the average of full cycle, because this waveform is not symmetrical, hence we have to go for full cycle. If we take the average values of for the full cycle, okay, so as this term is of cos 2 omega t, so it is varying the cosine wave. The average of the cosine wave over the full cycle is always zero. Hence hence average value of Vm Im cos 2 omega t is equal to 0. Hence the average will only remain what? Vm Im by 2. So if I split this 2 into root 2 root 2, so Vm by root 2, Im by root 2. Vm by root 2 is the RMS value of voltage, Im by root 2 is the RMS value of the current. So I can represent power in case of pure resistance as V into I, that is I square R, or I can say V square by R. The average power over a full cycle in pure resistance is the multiplication of RMS voltage and RMS current. So I will represent average power. The average power is the constant, which is the multiplication of RMS voltage into RMS current. Okay, now let us see what will happen if the AC is connected to the pure inductor. Okay, so keep in mind, though I am saying it is a pure inductor in the world, there is no existence of pure inductor. Every inductor has its own small resistance, but for analysis purpose we are neglecting here. Let us consider that the pure inductance of L Henry is connected across the AC supply of V is equal to Vm sin omega t. So this is the waveform of the voltage, that is V is equal to Vm sin omega t. That is the phasor which is in phase with the reference, that is V is in phase with the reference. So this is the phasor of Vm sin omega t. We know that EMF induced, whenever the current is flowing through this inductor, EMF is always induced in it, which is called as self-induced EMF. Self-induced EMF is given as E is equal to minus L di by dt. Okay, so minus L di by dt. This EMF generation is always in opposition to the applied voltage, is always in opposition to the applied voltage. So V is always equal to minus E. So V is equal to minus E, so minus minus will make it cancel. So V is equal to L di by dt. Okay, if I keep this di term over here, so di is equal to, I can write 1 by L V dt. So 1 by L, I want to calculate the current, so I will take the integration. If I take the integration of di is I, so 1 upon L integration of V dt. So V, but instantaneous voltage V is given by Vm sin omega t, so I will take this Vm at outside. So integration of sin omega t with respect to dt is minus cos omega t upon omega, so I will take that omega over here. So Vm upon omega L minus cos omega t. So what it indicate? Vm upon omega L, so minus cos omega t can be represented as sin omega t minus pi by 2. That is minus cos theta is equal to sin theta minus pi by 2. So I can represent the minus cos omega t as the sin omega t minus pi by 2. Okay, so Vm, so I can replace this omega L by the term XL. So let us see what is XL. So omega L sin omega t minus pi by 2. What it indicate here, if we observe the voltage and current equations, you will find that here is omega t minus pi by 2. Minus pi by 2 means minus 90 degree. That is, current phasor is lagging. Current is lagging to the voltage by 90 degree. That is, the current which is lagging to the voltage by 90 degree. That is, when voltage is maximum, current is 0. When voltage is 0, current is at its maximum. So red waveform is indicating that it is lagging to the voltage phasor by exactly pi by 2 degree. That is, current phasor is lagging to the voltage by 90 degree. Okay, so what is this XL? XL is given by, XL is known as the inductive reactance, and it is given by omega L. That is, XL is equal to omega L, and omega is always equal to 2 pi. So I can represent this as the 2 pi FL. Okay, XL is equal to how much? 2 pi FL. How will calculate what is inductive reactance? Inductive reactance is just like a resistance. Okay, V by R. Okay, so it's just like a resistance. Inductive reactance is defined as the opposition offered by the inductance of a circuit to the flow of alternating current. Okay, in case of pure conductor, current through its lagging to the applied voltage by pi by 2, that is 90 degree, that is, applied voltage leads to the current through it by 90 degree. Okay, let us calculate the instantaneous power. Instantaneous power P is equal to instantaneous voltage into instantaneous current, that is Vm sin omega t, and I is equal to Im sin omega t minus pi by 2. Im sin omega t minus pi by 2 can be represented as cos omega t. So Vm Im cos omega t minus cos omega t, so this minus sign is taken here. Sin omega t minus pi by 2 is minus cos omega t. So minus Vm Im sin omega t cos omega t. Sin omega t into cos omega t can be represented as sin 2 omega t by 2. Sin a into sin b is sin 2 a upon 2. So minus Vm Im by 2. If we take the average value of this over the full cycle, if I take the average value of this, as this is a sinusoidal term which is varying with the time, if I take this average value, it becomes 0. So if we see in this waveform, here voltage is positive, current is negative, so the multiplication of V into I is going towards the negative side. Again, it starts increasing. At this pi by 2, the current is 0, voltage is maximum, hence power is 0. Again, here both are positive in this region, hence the power starts increasing, again starts decreasing. At the pi, the voltage is 0, current is maximum, hence the power is 0. Here current is positive, voltage is negative, hence power becomes negative. Here current is negative, voltage is also negative, but the power becomes positive. If we observe that with respect to this omega t axis, the power is having the same waveform on the both sides, that is positive value and negative value over the half cycle. Average is always taken for the half cycle. Half cycle of the fundamental, for half cycle of fundamental, the average value of the power is becomes 0. Hence, P average will become equals to 0. Capital P is equal to 0. The average power consumption by the pure inductor is always given by 0 value. Now, let us see what is the AC through the capacitance. To calculate the AC through the capacitance, let the pure capacitance is connected across the the supply voltage V is equal to Vm sin omega t. Okay, Vm sin omega t. The voltage waveform is making the zero angle with respect to the reference. Hence, V phasor is in phase with the reference. So we know that I is equal to C dV by dt, but V is equal to Vm sin omega t. Substituting this value, so derivative of sin omega t with respect to dt is omega sin omega cos omega t. So omega c Vm cos omega t. I will take this omega c term in the denominator, so I can write Vm divided by 1 upon omega c. So omega c is taken into the denominator, 1 upon omega c cos omega t Vm by xc. So 1 upon omega c is replaced by the term xc. Sin omega t cos omega t can be written as sin omega t plus pi by 2. Okay, here we will observe that the current is leading to the voltage by pi by 2. In inductor, it is lagging. Here, it is leading to the voltage by 90 degree, where XC is known as the capacitive reactance. XC is equal to 1 upon omega C, that is XC is equal to 1 upon 2 pi FC. This is known as a capacitive reactance. Capacitive reactance is defined as the opposition offered by the capacitance. It is defined as the opposition offered by the capacitance of a circuit to the flow of alternating current. Okay. So Vm by XC sin omega t plus pi by 2, or Im sin omega t plus pi by 2. In case of pure capacitor, current through it is leading to the applied voltage by 90 degree. That is, applied voltage is lagging to the current by 90 degree. Okay, so current is, in case of pure capacitance, the current is leading to the voltage by 90 degree. That is, voltage lagging to the current by 90 degree. So how will calculate the instantaneous power? V into I, Vm sin omega t, Im sin omega t plus pi by 2. Again, as the same case in case of the inductor, he will observe that average power of Vm Im 2 sin 2 omega t is again 0. So in case of the in case of pure capacitance also, both are positive, hence the power is positive. Here the current is negative, voltage is positive, hence power is negative. Here both are negative, hence power is positive. If we observe that the average power over the half cycle is also 0. So the power average is also 0. That is, average power consumption by the pure capacitance is given by 0. There is no power consumption by the pure capacitor. Thank you.